Halo Infinite PC specs, as well as the Xbox One being dropped? Well, I answered that and a lot more of your questions in this video, so stay tuned throughout the whole thing to understand all the details. So occasionally on this channel, I do like to reach out to you guys, ask you a question of, do you have anything you want to know more of when it comes to Halo Infinite? As we are a channel that covers all the news and information about the game, I'm sure not everyone catches up with everything, so this is a great video to kind of get some questions answered by the community here. Which I do these Q&A videos quite often, so you guys want to take part in the next Q&A, make sure you subscribe to the channel to catch those community posts when they do go live. But let's jump right into the content here. The first question is from EX Varen. What minimum slash recommended specs do they aim to hit? And what kind of performance can we expect from those configs? That's a very interesting question because Halo Infinite set itself up to be the most accessible Halo ever, right? We have a free-to-play multiplayer. We have the game on multiple platforms, multiple generations of platforms as well. So 343 needs to take this into mind when it comes to developing the game. And so then more people get a chance to enjoy it. And it's not just for like the high-end people or just for the people on Xbox. Halo Infinite's for everyone. And when it comes to that kind of stuff, sometimes concessions need to be made, something like the intensity of graphics. So far, the game I think of the most when it comes to pushing the graphics engine as far as possible would definitely have to be Cyberpunk, and well, that definitely became an issue on the last gen consoles for Cyberpunk, where it became a whole debacle over thing. I think they even got sued over it. So you can't push the graphics so hard to where only high-end Xbox and high-end PC users can enjoy the game, but you also can't make the graphics so low res and not that impressive to where people don't feel like they're getting a next gen experience. I would expect to see the specs kind of line up around something around the competition of what's out there. So something like a Call of Duty Warzone or like an Apex Legends, something like that. So if you can run those games on PC, I would assume to see that Halo Infinite would be able to run on those similar PCs. So for comparison, we jumped onto the Activision PC recommended and minimum specs for Call of Duty Warzone on PC. Let's take a look at the recommended, because minimum specs is like at least you can run the game kind of thing. Recommended specs are kind of where the ideally where you want to at least be. And this runs it at 60 frames per second, which is definitely where you'd want to be, or settings are set to medium. I'm assuming at 1080p resolution as well. For CPU, we have an i5-2500K, an AMD Ryzen 5 1600X processor, 12 gigabytes of RAM. You're gonna need a lot of hard drive space for this game, that's for sure. And for a video card, they say an NVIDIA GTX 970/1660 or a Radeon 89390 or AMD RX 580. Taking a quick look on the Apex Legends website as well, they showcase that a CPU of an i5-3570K or equivalent, 8 gigabytes of RAM, a GTX 970 with a Radeon R9-290, and only 22 gigabytes of space, but I think it might need a little bit more than that now. Though I do feel like Infinite's gonna push the graphics a little bit more than these two games, so I'd say like a 1080, 1080 Ti graphics card, and equivalent to that would probably be your best guess. That's currently what I have right now. And I'm feeling rather confident with that graphics card jumping into Halo Infinite. Yeah, you probably won't be able to enjoy the RTX, which hopefully we'll have at launch, but I feel like if you can run those games fine, you probably will be able to run Halo Infinite just fine as well. The prototype asks, how does Halo Infinite look to your eyes? Does it look like a 2010-2013 game? Because I shared the new screenshots with some friends and they said it looks like a game from 2010. I was a bit upset. So I'm also asking you about your thoughts on the graphics of this game. Does it look next gen to you? I would say yes, that this game looks next gen for Halo. This is the largest, most expansive game we've ever seen for Halo Infinite. Obviously it's the campaign gameplay and it's very wide open and expansive, which has to render a lot more assets, which is much more demanding. And it's all in real time lighting, which is even more demanding about it, while running at least 1080p, 60 frames per second easily. When you think of 2010-2013 games, I can't help but think of Halo Reach, which I believe ran at 720p, didn't have dynamic lighting, and also ran at 30 frames per second. And honestly, when I saw the gameplay reveal, I thought the graphics were good. I was just more upset about the functionality of these graphics, where you saw a lot of pop-in textures, that the grass you saw kind of like disappeared and reappeared kind of thing. I was more upset about the functionality of the graphics and the geometry rather than the actual visuals of the game, because I thought the game looked great. Honestly, like, remember when my first reaction to the game was like, wow, these graphics are looking great. Though I will say that the further distance graphics and textures were very muddy and kind of low res, where we've seen the most recent screenshots from Halo Infinite's development, that has been kind of helped out a lot with this extra development time, where the detail is definitely there and the objects are further away now. And I would agree that the gameplay that we saw in 2020 was just a game that wasn't ready for release that year. I think Halo Infinite will be ready for release in 2021. I think it will be looking great. Another thing about the graphics you also have to take in consideration is, again, like I kind of touched on earlier, is performance, right? I saw a screenshot showcasing the difference between the new Zero Horizon game that's going to be on PlayStation and Halo Infinite, and how Zero Horizon had much more vibrant colors, much more detail, and all these crazy kind of visuals to it, right? But the thing is, now it's been revealed that the new Horizon game is going to be playing at 30 frames per second. In 2021, playing at 30 frames per second, which is half the processing power needed compared to 60 frames per second, which we will be getting with Halo Infinite. So Horizon Dawn might be like visually more appealing of a game, right? But at what cost? Are you willing to play at 30 frames? I'm not with Halo. So when it comes to graphical quality, it's just an entire balance of, you know, really high visual quality and performance. It's this never-ending balance that, you know, developers are trying to get for us, and it depends on how the art style looks and the kind of game that they want to accomplish. With the large scale of Halo Infinite, they have to tone down the graphics quality a little bit to compensate to have better performance. It's just like a yin-yang kind of thing. Master Prime 901 asks, if Halo Infinite is going to launch on Xbox One and Halo Infinite will have a 10-year plan of content, do you think that the Xbox One version will be dropped at some point? And do you think that the Xbox One version of Halo Infinite will affect the other versions? I think it kind of goes without saying, with a 10-year plan, eventually the old consoles are going to get dropped. We're going to see this kind of like how Destiny kind of went about dropping their old consoles, which I believe that the Rise of Iron DLC was not available on the PS3 and Xbox 360, if I remember correctly. And eventually it will just be kind of phased out. When do I expect to see that happen? Probably maybe like a year after, we probably start seeing some phasing out or some features not making it to the game, and then probably like in 2023 to see no support whatsoever for the Xbox One version when it comes to new content, just because at that point it'd be a decade old console that you're trying to support with a, you know, brand new game they're trying to deliver a next gen experience on. So eventually that's going to happen. Obviously with the debacle of Cyberpunk's release on the last gen consoles, people are wondering if it's going to hold back Halo Infinite's optimal potential, and maybe just a little bit when it comes to that kind of stuff. But also, you can lower down frame rates, like we mentioned earlier, you can lower down resolutions, you can lower draw distance and things like that, to where the Xbox One version of the game will definitely be visually inferior, but maybe the gameplay experience itself will still hold up all right. But Cyberpunk, the difference between the last gen and current gen consoles was just so huge, and I just don't think people were ready for that harsh hit of reality. Pretty much Halo Infinite's environment also looks to be much more kind of like rolling natural hills environment, not so cluttered kind of urban environments with AI walking all over the place like we saw with Cyberpunk. So that definitely will help on the hardware demand of the system itself. But I mean, possibly we could see some holding back of it just to make sure that the people who are playing on Xbox One don't feel so left out. But I would assume within 2 years to drop all content support altogether for the Xbox One. U2Yo20 asks, has the recent Inside Infinite made you jealous of PC players being able to boost 21:9 plus aspect ratios on Infinite? Do you personally even care? And do you think splurging the extra money for an ultra-wide monitor and gaming PC or Infinite is even worth it? I personally don't really know anyone who games on ultra wide or even really even has an ultra wide monitor. I have one friend who has an ultra wide monitor, but he mainly uses it for music production. The vast majority of people will be playing on 16:9 monitors, as most people do, as it's probably the most optimal way to play, because anything wider than that, you kind of lose peripheral awareness. And when it comes to a shooter like Halo, stuff like that's really important. I think the reason why we saw such a huge emphasis on ultra-wide monitor support is because it's like actually kind of a rare thing to have done. And so to have Halo Infinite have support for ultra-wide monitors showcases how much extra effort that they're putting into the PC platform to make it known that, hey, this is not just a port, this is a true PC version of Halo Infinite. Do I feel like an ultra-wide monitor is worth it? Not really, as I don't really feel like it would really give you any kind of advantage or make you enjoy the game any more than you already can. And just from my experience and knowledge of people who use it, it's a very small percentage of people who will be using ultra-wide setups. So I don't really feel that their emphasis on ultra-wide means that this game is designed for ultra-wide. I think it's just more just a showcase that they've taken time and effort and care into the PC version to give support to compared to other games which don't necessarily share the same kind of support. And sticking with the PC questions, Edric Dane asks, I'm pretty sad to see no mention of PC split screen. In your opinion, what are the chances? I would say for PC split screen, the chances are pretty slim to none, as it's not really a feature that's utilized a whole lot. Like, I know there's people out there who hook up their PCs to their TV and they, you know, will do split screen that way. But it is actually a rather small group of people who would do that. When it comes to PC split screen, I feel like there are higher priorities when it comes to PC features and having things within the game, like having it run properly, DLSS support, ray tracing support, and things like that, which you still don't know about. And performance is my biggest thing when it comes to this game, as from the reveal in 2020 that the performance of the game wasn't very well done. So even though split screen on PC is great, and honestly I probably would use it with my Steam Link, I would just rather see the effort put towards something else. But that doesn't mean that it will never happen. Halo Infinite is a game that's designed for 10 years of lasting, and there will be more features added to the game. So things like split screen could possibly come down the line. It's not all about the launch for Halo Infinite, though it is an important thing. Don't get me wrong, it's important to nail the launch of the game. Though, you gotta keep in mind that also this is a long-term play. We don't have to wait like 3 years, 4 years for a new game to come out to get new features, because Infinite's designed to have features come and go. They can be developed on, added in, improvement in visuals and graphics throughout its lifespan. And so it's not 100% about the launch, even though yes, the launch is very important, but we could possibly see it coming down the line. If you guys have been out of the loop for Halo for the last few days or so, or missed any content from me recently, check out the videos on the screen right here. You can link to all my news and informational videos right there. So thank you so much for watching. I greatly appreciate it. I'll catch you on the next one. Peace out.